Hello, I'm Laura Nicolosi with NASA's Office of Inspector General. Spaceflight is an inherently risky endeavor, and NASA's goal to conduct a crewed mission to Mars by the 2030s will expose astronauts to new and increased hazards. In October 2015, we released an audit examining NASA's efforts to manage health and human performance risks posed by space exploration. To better understand and mitigate risks, NASA and its partners are performing a variety of studies on Earth and on the International Space Station. While the agency has developed strategies to reduce the impact of most risks associated with travel to the station, many long-term space travel risks are not fully understood. These include behavioral health issues, inadequate food and nutrition, space radiation, vision impairments, and intracranial pressure. Multiple NASA offices play a role in developing procedures, medications, devices, and other countermeasures to mitigate these risks. We reported that although NASA continues to improve its process for identifying and managing health and human performance risks associated with spaceflight, given the current state of knowledge, the agency's risk mitigation schedule is optimistic, and NASA will not develop countermeasures for many deep space risks until the early 2030s. Uncertainty about the mass, volume, and weight of potential deep space vehicles and habitats limits more timely development of countermeasures that will lower risks to a level commensurate with agency standards for low Earth orbit missions. As such, astronauts on at least the initial deep space missions will likely have to accept higher levels of risk than those who fly the space station missions. NASA's management of crew health risks could benefit from increased efforts to use expertise from a variety of health and science-related disciplines, both inside and outside the agency. Currently, NASA lacks a coordinated, integrated, and strategic approach for integrating life sciences and other experts, which may result in more time-consuming and costly efforts to develop countermeasures. Finally, for missions with limited countermeasures, NASA will have to determine the level of acceptable risk and clearly communicate this to astronauts, Congress, and the public. With this in mind, NASA needs to continue to explore whether its current healthcare model for astronauts is sufficient to meet both long health needs of the astronaut community and the research needs of the agency. We made 6 recommendations to assist NASA as it continues to develop a comprehensive approach to understanding and addressing human and health performance risks to agency missions. NASA concurred or partially concurred with each and proposed corrective actions. To read the full OIG report, please visit our website at www.oig.nasa.gov.